city.
I just spent 2.5 years in Iowa, which is a little chillier than this, so I guess we're kind of used to being a little bit colder. Others took extra measures.
Dwayne DeShazer put on thermals and plenty of extra clothes before his commute from Pottstown to East Falls. But it was the impact of the cold on his daughter that was on his mind.
My baby, my grandparents stay in the house. We want to stay out to keep warm. More or less, my child. We feel like a daycare home.
Officials are advising residents to check on loved ones, especially the elderly and infirm, to make sure they have shelter and heat. As for what to know about a cold, it triggers shelters to open up beds and outreach efforts to make sure the homeless come in from the cold. The code blue in Montgomery County is in effect through Thursday. City officials have said they are not setting an end date for the code blue at this time. They are asking anyone who needs shelter to go to any of their intake centers, and there are 6 of those spread around the city. I'm Matt Cole. KYW News Radio 103.9 FM.
A longer halt to the fighting between Israel and Hamas, with the CIA director entering talks to free more hostages. We'll have more on that straight ahead, but first, we bring you traffic and weather on the twos as we take you now to the PJ Fitzpatrick Home Improvement Traffic Center. What's going on, Stevie?
There's some jammed traffic on 295 westbound. That's the old 95 southbound. As you approach the Pennsylvania Turnpike, it's the left lane that's blocked there. The left lane's blocked on the northbound side. Eastbound side as well, but we're only seeing to a backup. If you're coming off of the Turnpike Connector Bridge from PA into Jersey, past the 130 ramps, looks like there's a little bit of a slowdown in there. I'm not sure why. Things are looking all right. Up and down 295, we're in really good shape. 42 north and southbound, no problems to report either. Well, because they reopened these ramps at about 4 o'clock this morning, or rather opened them anyway. So if you're on 42 northbound to 295 southbound, you now have direct access. 295 northbound to 42 southbound, also open. All restrictions have been cleared in the area. There's still some work to be done, but they're not talking about closing those ramps again. We'll keep you posted. Things are looking pretty good. If you go over across the Ben Franklin Bridge into PA, looking fine on the Vine Street Expressway. The Schuylkill Expressway is remarkably clear. Westbound, it's slow at City Avenue, and that's about it. On City Avenue, both ways, right in front of St. Joseph's, you've got jammed traffic because of construction. Mass Transit, no major issues at this point. So if you see something on the roads, we always like hearing from you. The KYW traffic tip line is 215-724-1060. Next update, less than 10 minutes. I'm Stevie Reese.
Thanks, Stevie. And now to that 5-day forecast. And we check in with AccuWeather meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
A couple of snow showers have been progressing through the area so far this morning. This has caused briefly reduced visibilities and some light coatings of snow in places, particularly on elevated surfaces. The first batch of these snow showers will move east of the city during the late morning hours, but with an upper-level trough yet to swing through the area, we anticipate a couple more to head into the afternoon hours. In between, we'll see intervals of sunshine along with a gusty west wind, high temperature of 39 being more typical of the dead of winter in late January. Combined with those winds, and the accurate real field temperature won't be any higher than the 20s the rest of today. Skies will turn out mainly clear tonight, with a stiff breeze persisting, a low of 26 in Center City. And rain cold and brisk tomorrow, sun and cloud will lie again 39. These is Thursday, more sunshine, the high 50. Maybe the last sun we see for a few days. A weakening storm will bring us cloud Friday, along with some rain in the afternoon and evening, the high 52. Saturday looks mostly cloudy but dry, the high 53, more rain likely for Sunday. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
And we're at 37 degrees under a mostly sunny sky in Center City. We're climbing up to a high of 39 today.
Violence in the Middle East. Ongoing coverage of the Israel-Hamas war on KYW News Radio.
We should be seeing another round of hostage and prisoner exchanges between Israel and Hamas today after both sides agreed to extend their pause in fighting. And that will last through tomorrow. We'll also allow more aid to flow into Gaza. CIA Director William Burns has arrived in Qatar for meetings involving the war, including discussions about Hamas hostages. More people were freed by both sides Monday. This included 11 Israeli women and children and 33 Palestinian prisoners. CBS News correspondent Nicole Skenga has more.
Monday's exchange did not include any Americans.
We hope that more Americans will come out here in these next two installments, but we'll have to wait and see.
Qatar announced the ceasefire was extended for 2 more days, also raising hope for families of others forced into Gaza during last month's terror attack. Secretary of State Antony Blinken is returning to Israel this week to stress the need for all the hostages to be freed and to sustain increased humanitarian assistance to Gaza.
State Department said Blinken would also discuss efforts to protect civilian life during Israel's operations in Gaza. The U.S. has pledged to support Israel during its counteroffensive, but Blinken has also said far too many Palestinians have been killed. Now, one of the three men of Palestinian descent who was shot in Burlington, Vermont, has been released from the hospital. We're not being told his name because of security concerns, but the mother of Kenan Abdul-Hamid, a student at Haverford College, has said she expected him to be released soon because his injuries were less serious. CBS News correspondent Errol Barnett reporting from Burlington.
Rich Price and Roddy Tamimi are uncles of two of the men.
The last thing that we imagined could be possible was that in our family neighborhood, they would walk down the street and this would happen.
Tamimi says he's struggling with the decision to bring his nephew, Kenan, to the U.S. from the West Bank.
We figured it would be good for him to be here. It would be safe.
The suspected shooter, 48-year-old Jason Eaton, pleaded not guilty to three counts of attempted murder yesterday and was ordered held without bail. Police say when they knocked on his door to arrest him, he told them, quote, "I've been waiting for you." Well, the morning commute for more than 150,000 drivers in South Jersey just got a tad easier. The new ramps connecting 42 and 295 have now opened. KYW's Nina Barati has more.
New Jersey Department of Transportation officials say the Missing Moves project is one that's been talked about for decades, but construction didn't start until March of 2020. Steve Shapiro, press manager for the New Jersey DOT, says the project is all done right on time. One is situated on Route 42 northbound, right after the merge from Route 55. The other ramp entrance on 295 heading north is on the right-hand side of the highway before the merge with 76. Nina Barati, KYW News Radio, 103.9 FM.
Well, in light of recent warnings by the CDC, Pennsylvania health officials are sounding the alert on testing for syphilis amidst the disturbing rise in syphilis cases in newborns. We get more on this from KYW Community Impact reporter Raquel Williams.
The CDC recently reported that newborn syphilis cases were rising across the country at an alarming rate, and health officials in the Commonwealth are now taking action.
We encourage healthcare providers to emphasize the importance of testing for syphilis to their patients, especially women of childbearing age. Testing is recommended in three stages of pregnancy.